Hey guys, this is episode 78 of Modded Minecraft. This is Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved. So, last episode we were, you know, pretty much working hard on the ME system here. We made the terminal and we pretty much got our very first deep storage hooked up to the ME system. And I've done a little bit more work since then. Now, we've opened it up, as you can see, I've added even more stuff to the ME system here. But the problem is, the biggest problem we're going to encounter very bloomin' soon is obviously the amount of channels that I'm going through. If we pop down here and we highlight this, up the top, in the center of the screen, it says 7 of 8 channels. Yes. So we're going to have to upgrade to some dense cabling very, very soon. Okay. So, but with this episode, we're going to give it a break because we've been working quite a lot on the ME system here. So we're going to give it a break, but I'll just catch you guys up what I've done off cam. So I've gone ahead and started obviously clearing out now. This is our big storage / computer area. I don't know what you're going to call it. But as you can see, I've got the deep storage units stacked on this side. We're going to have it stacked on this side. Remember, we're going to have drive bays all in here. And we're going to put a door in here. So you open it up, we have drive bays going and deep storage. It's going to be bloody epic. But for now, I've started moving all my deep storage units into it, but we've got only a few hooked up so far with the storage buses here. So, but it's taking up bloomin' channels up the bloody yazoo. So, gonna do the same with the other side. So all this is now hooked up. Well, these six here are hooked up, then this down has got to be hooked up eventually. So, and obviously we've got to make our very first ME drive, which I'm not looking for. That looks kind of complicated, not complicated, just long process, and we're going to make a 64 drive. We'll talk about that later with the dense cable. We're going to take a break. I've been working on the ME system for a little bit now, so we're going to take a break. I've actually been working quite hard over in the project world, sucking, fluid vacuuming, and putting pumps and stuff down, and trying to clean up the best I can, like, because, man, that project, really want that project to get going. So what we'll do is I'll head out there real quick to the project, just catch you guys up what's going on in the project world. So off to the project. Now, it's such a slow process because it's such a large area. People do not realize how large this bloody area actually is at the end of the day. It is freaking ridiculously large. But I'm chipping away at it day by day by day by day by day. Slowly and surely, we'll bloomin' get there, guys. We will bloomin' get there. So, as you can see, a lot. If we stand back here, look at that. All the way around the platform, being just going nuts with fluivacs and pumps and vacuums and you name it. We've got some of the people even from the server out here giving me a hand sometimes. You know, they pop out here, maybe spend half hour fluivacking. But as you can see, I got pumps and stuff setting up, getting rid of lava all left, right, and bloomin' center. We did a live stream a little while ago, setting up more and more pumps, and we found this evil layer of doom down there, which obviously we've got to remove at some point soon. But as you can see, this old pump platforms I've got to get rid of from the live stream that we did a long time, well, not long time, well, actually about half a week ago, something like that. It is coming along. Like, there is, if this would load, crikey, I know there's a lot of stuff going on in this section, but there is another pump through here. I don't know, there should be another pump around here somewhere, and it will load up in a second. Will it load up? Oh, crikey. It's been a bit of a pain in the bum. Bit of a pain in the bum. So, that's how the project's going. And as, see, it is clearing up. Like, if you stand back here and look at our center of the project, it's actually, yeah, a lot has been done. So, but eventually, remember, my goal is not to suck out the bottom lava lakes. This stuff down here, this here, is lava lakes. Not bothered. Bedrock, I'm not bothered. Nothing spawns on the bedrock, okay? All I want to do is get rid of all these freaking floating pillars. Just so I can start either a mining turtle, start laying slabs, or we use our builder's wand, because that was quite fancy, and we sort of lay nice fancy slabs from here. See here? This is where the old lava lake is. Ouch! I hate these freaking bats! They drive me up the wall. And then we just sort of half slab outwards all the way around to the edges, so you won't be able to see the lava lakes underneath. And the plan is obviously to get rid of anything that anything can spawn on. But nothing spawns on the bedrock on the bottom down here, so that's fine. We don't stress about that. So that all will be covered up eventually. Things just fall off. Like, this slime didn't take any fall damage. But things in the middle here get intense. Like, this is really the only spot they can spawn at the moment. So, you know, it gets quite intense at times. But all back here, look at this. It's all exposed and it's doing an absolutely wonderful job. As I said, a while ago now, we did the live stream. I might link it in the description just in case people have missed it and you don't know what I'm talking about. What are you blooming talking about, Data? See, this pump is ready to be moved. Yeah, this pump here is ready to be moved. Look at it. It's sort of cleared out underneath it. It's quite cool. Yeah, so project is still chugging along. Look at it. It's absolutely stunning. Very clear and open nearly now. Absolutely awesome. But that's chugging along. It's going to take a while. I really did underestimate how long it was going to actually take. It's going to take a freaking butt ton, but it's going to be worth it. We're going to build a really cool farm in the middle here eventually. Okay, so those should be all still functioning, right? No, I think all the pumps need to be moved, to be honest. All right, let's head on home real quick. So that's not what we're doing today. Today we're going to go out to my lava world and we're going to set up, because I'm just about to get in the process of building more 64x lava generators. But you know what the pain in the bum bit about building my lava world real quick. About these lava generators and this lava world. This lava world is bloody awesome. But the biggest problem is moving it. See all these star patterns, like, you guys know the drill. This is all from ender pumps, you know. They do a wonderful job of sucking out. Like, this here is 64 blocks deep of lava. It lasts more than 24 hours before a pump needs to be moved, which is bloody fantastic. But it's just a pain in the bum. So either you're going to split up the pumps, or I've got another bloomin' idea. So I passed on this idea to King Willy, actually, for him to test. So what I said to him is pretty much, why don't we use an ender quarry with a pump upgrade, just in a normal speed, to do 1,000 by 1,000 in this 64 deep lava world, because it's all just lava. Technically, it would act like a pump, wouldn't it? Sucking out lava, right? And you wouldn't have to move it because, you know, there's a range limiter on the normal pumps, right? That don't allow them to go very, very far at all. I think that's like, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, well, I'd say about 7 chunks or something maximum in each direction, and not even including the corners. But yeah, no, well, I told him, I said, why don't we just use an ender quarries for pumps? You know, especially don't put any speed upgrades or any upgrades on it so it doesn't chew a lot of power. And then build a few more bloomin' lava generators. So he's like, that's a bloomin' good idea. So he went out and he did 1,000 by 1,000, and I was pretty much right there. Apparently, it does the job. It sucks lava up quite well. I'm like, really? He's like, yeah, you got to do it. So I'm like, oh god, we got to get hooked up really quick, because I just moved this sucker here. This here is obviously our power source. This guy here powers everything, which is absolutely blooming awesome. Right now there is no energy left because of the mining. Oh no, we've got one here with a full buffer. Yeah, we got one with a full buffer right now. Oh, two with a full buffer, sorry. What, do we have full buffer? Yeah, well, okay, we've got multiples with full buffers right now. But instead of using this guy here, which is an endothermic pump, sorry, and just an 8x lava generator on top of that to power the thermic pump, we actually use a full-blown quarry as the thing. So he said it seemed to work, and he said he had to upgrade the pipes, though. He said these pipes weren't, the hardened fluid ducts weren't doing a trick, so we might have to do the same thing. I don't know, but we're going to set one of those up, because obviously that's just going to eliminate moving our pumps for a while until we get a new power source. And as I said, I'm in the process of actually making more lava, these 64-mile lava generators. I actually want to double this and make a nice stacker. So instead of having this pump here, we might just have a quarry pump it in. But we'll see. So first things first, we're going to leave this alone for now. What I want to do is fly. What I want to do, because this is going to be a big project, so I want to fly out a little bit over, you know, in one direction is fine, and find myself a little platform. Here we go. Bob's your uncle. This is going to be our starting platform, okay? We're going to move all our pumps and power station and all everything right here. So this will be it. Dude, I didn't even bring any blocks to put down the hole. That kind of sucks. But anyway, what we'll do is press J, waypoint, and we'll set up new, and we'll call it, I don't know, we'll call it Ender Pump. So, as in, like, Ender Pump Quarry. And we'll change it to blue, or just some sort of neon color so it's not crazy. Safe. Alright, so that's saved. This is where our new project, little project, is going to undertake. And I've got Ender Quarries on me right now, but obviously I need to place blocks. Obviously, if I'm going to put quarries in here, so we could probably put a quarry in. No, we can't put a quarry in right now. What we'll do is I need to make that block that allows you to place. See, the worst thing about coming out here and moving stuff is I have to find these little places. Because remember, this is 64 blocks deep. This is very, very deep lava. So the worst thing about coming out here and building the pumps is you've got to find one of these to build off of, because so you don't have to scaffold out. Now, a lot of people have been recommending in the past to build this block called an angel block or something, and apparently that allows you to place blocks in midair. How freaking cool is that? So we might go put one of those back together before we start on this project and give that a test run, because that's going to come in handy in the future anyway. You know, crikey. So we'll head on home, which home is in this direction. I nearly went the wrong bloody way there. So I'm probably going to use two ender quarries. He only used one ender quarry for his test run. I'm going to use two ender quarries with two lava bucket upgrades. And we're going to see how it goes from there. It shouldn't use too much power because we don't have speed 3 upgrades or anything like that. It won't be getting anything but pretty much pure liquid lava. It's used as a pump. This will hopefully allow us to not move our lava generators in a... Well, not a lava generator, but any quarry in like a week. It's going to make a mess out here. Don't get me wrong. It is going to make a bloomin' mess. I do admit that. But that's not my problem, is it? No, it's not. So we'll head on home really quickly, put one of these new angel blocks together and see how this all's going to work out. So they're quite cheap and easy to make. I looked it up. They're obsidian and gold block. Not gold block, gold bar and two couple of feathers, I'm pretty sure. Bob's your bloomin' uncle. So, this is a good, gives me a good opportunity moment to show you guys my mining world. I keep forgetting to update people on my mining world. So, if we head out to my mining world really quickly, which is currently being powered by, obviously, the power here. Check this out. So, she's obviously running as we speak right now. You should see the amount of resources I've got out here. Check that out. That's a lot of cobblestone right there. Freaking geez. Dirt, and we've got gravel, but we've got, you should see this, like, where's diamond? 12,000 bloody stacks of diamonds. Look at this. Boom. Ta-da. Look at that. That was freaking awesome. Put them all back. There we go. All right. Put all those back, but holy smokes. Like, the amount of resources I'm getting. Look at that. That's almost, it looks like 300k freaking worth of iron ore. That's bloody nuts. Absolutely freaking nuts. So, obviously, I'm collecting it. I'm hoarding everything. All these, guys, is going back to, all these deep storage are going to go back to the ME. So, obviously, soon, when this quarry's done, I'm not sure when this quarry will be done, I'm going to pack all this up, and we're just going to use a tesseract to transfer the items from our mining world back to our ME system. That's going to be, I'm going to have to do research on how to do all that and all that crazy stuff. But yeah, all these suckers, all these mass amounts of items here, say 68,000 freaking lapis, they're all going to be hooked in to obviously the ME system at the end of the blooming day. Freaking nuts amount of redstone right there. Crikey. You name it, it's in here. So, tons of nether brick. It's hit, 1500 freaking draconic dust. Absolutely bloody awesome. So I come out here for a reason, not just to show you guys the amount of ores. I come out here to grab some, not pocket coal, obsidian. That's what I come out here to grab. One of these are all my old mining chests, as you guys know. And I've set them up so they're easy. Uh-oh. Oh, whoa, blooming lag spike right bloody there. I set them up for easy access, but... Oh, here we go. We'll grab a stack of obsidian, because we're going to need it for this recipe, that we, this angel block, which we're going to be bloody making. And, yeah, Croggy. Alrighty then, guys. I am back. I've gone and gathered all the resources up already. So, I've got some gold. I've only got 12 feathers. That's all I can find. So, I'm not going to be able to make too many of these blimmin' things. I'll tell you that for a fact. Which kind of sucks. I was hoping I would have a few stacks of feathers laying around. But no, I don't have a few stacks of feathers. I had to get these out of the enchanting room as it bloody was. Crikey. So, just to double check that the wiki was all correct here. Because that would be quite embarrassing right now. So angel block, there she is right there. Yep, feathers, gold, okay, not as much as I thought. I thought it maybe it was two stacks of gold on both sides and feathers up the top, but that's complete opposite. That's okay, that is blooming okay. Alright, through there, split this up so it looks like we have six of them. There we go, boom. Alright, we have six, I repeat, six of these guys. We'll pop these in here just for now. Out of the blooming way. That's all for the ME. Alright, so we've got angel blocks here. Place one on the ground. We can break it with a pick. It's pretty much instant break. And according to the wiki, it gives it back to you right away. So, see, we can stand all the way back here and we don't have to run into the item. See how we got five in our inventory of these angel blocks already? Break it instantly back in. How cool is that? Apparently, if you look up... Yep, oh, that's blooming awesome. That is blooming freaking awesome. And get it back like that. So if we're flying, if we're in hover mode, and yep, we can literally place it underneath us and get it back instantly without it disintegrating. That is freaking awesome. We now have, God, that was so cheap too. That was so bloody cheap. What was I thinking? All right, so I've got markers and I've got four ender quarries. I don't know why I got four. I don't need that many. And I've got the freaking pump upgrades as well. Okay, so we're going to head on out and I'm going to lay the marker. The markers are going to take a while to lay for me anyway. We'll fly out there really quick and start set. Oh, that's right. Before we fly out there, we got nothing to build on. So what we'll do is freaking grab maybe a stack of marble or something. Out of this chest. There we go. That'll be fine to bloody build with. Absolutely blooming fine. So we'll head on out there now to the lava world. Ba-boom. All right. Fly over to our new pumping station real quick and just roughly set up what our new setup's going to be like. I think this is going to work like I think. We're not going to have to move this sucker in a whole week. Not every 24 hours. In a whole bloody week, I don't have to come out here and move this. It's going to be blooming awesome. Maybe even more. I don't know how long 1,000 by 1,000 is going to take to drain with lava source wise. You could probably run the pump over it again because we already know how real bad ender quarries are at picking up 100% of the source blocks, aren't we? Or removing everything. But as I said, my sources are good. Willie's tested the idea out and he said it works absolutely brilliantly. So you never know. I'm going to have to do this now. If he's trolling and this is going to be a sucky idea, this is going to be bad. All right, out here. Right past this. Far out. I built so far out. But then again, there's patches. We don't want to hit one of the massive patches of stone block. Because we don't want it to be picking up stone. We just want it to be sucking up lava. That's it. That's all we want this thing to be doing. Okay. Alright. Here is the new setup. Whoop. Brakes. Brakes. Down we go. Whoop. Alright. So, we'll fill that up. And we'll just... make a nice little platform for us to work on. Okay, so what we'll do is we're going to take two ender quarries, right? We're going to build those two ender quarries near off the blooming ground so we can work with them. Boom, 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 boom. So really what I wanted to do was do this section here with one of them, but it's not going to work out because... I just realized that they're going to interfere. So even if I wanted to do that, it's going to connect. The boundaries are going to connect, which is not good. So I want a boundary like that. So maybe we'll do one at a time. One at a time. Unless I do like a crossway, one at a time. So we'll just break this for now because we don't want that setting up. Give me that back. Oh, give me that back. All right. So that there is our first marker, okay? We're going to fly whoop whoop in that direction. Of 1,000 blocks there. We only need an L. That's it. We only need an L to establish a boundary, okay? And then Yeah. Then we can go ahead and get you started. So I'll be back shortly. I'm going to put these other markers down with the new angel blocks, by the way. So we're flying. We'll be flying out there. We don't need the pumps anymore. So we'll be flying with the hover mode and everything active. And we could literally now, we should be able to just literally go down here. Boom. Like that. So that's going to be blooming awesome. So much easier. We can get it back instantly by breaking it, not losing it in the lava. Okay. So I'll be back shortly, guys. Alrighty then, guys, I am back, and I've gone ahead and moved everything out here. I've gone ahead and made tons more hardened fluid duct, even made the upgraded fluid duct there. That was actually quite difficult. Even made the best freaking servo. I've been doing a metric butt ton of bloomin' work. But what was biggest pain in the bum was laying, obviously, our freaking quarry here. It's already established a boundary, which is quite good. For some reason, my mini-map is not... Well, none of my stuff is working. Look at this. It's, like, glitched out for some reason. I have no bloomin' clue. So, which is not good. But I've built a platform safe for us. And, as I said, that quarry's established. I've put a brand new tesseract on top and a pump upgrade on the bottom. So, the plan is, now, we're going to go ahead and add a nullifier. Because this is, he's going to be... That's going to obviously... sending and receiving and stuff like that. So let's go ahead and put a... Oh, crikey. We need one more, but we'll get it shortly. We're going to put a nullifier there, okay? And we're going to tell it to bottom. So hopefully, I'm hoping any items that the ender quarry do suck up, because remember, there is patches of obsidian and water, which we've got to take care of, because we can't pump, obviously, the freaking quarry pump, obviously, cannot pump that water into the generators. That's obviously bad. And also, the items can't be pumped in there, too, so hopefully, all items from the nullifier now will go instantly into that. So we shouldn't have a problem with that. Now, I've got a barrel for the water, which is a bedrockium drum, which I'm going to pop at the bottom. And I'm going to actually go get a bucket of water myself and pour it in to the drum so it doesn't fill up with lava, obviously. So we'll do that right now. And then I've got to run all the way blooming home, and hopefully unloading this world and loading this world is going to fix my map problem. Because look, I can't even see the markers. Can you see the markers? What the hell? I've never seen this glitch before. So, I don't know what's going on there. It's a big bug going on. But, we can pour ourselves that bucket of water straight in here. Boom. So it becomes a water drum. So I'm hoping now all water out of the test rack will go into there, obviously. And we're going to use our brain smacker new... where are you? I can only make 54 of them. That's all I can make of the... I don't know why I brought bloody these new servers. I was usually going to use that for something else. We're going to make some more... Well, I can only make a certain amount of these. Look at these. Look how beautiful they absolutely look. Hang on. Hover mode enabled. I'm hoping these new fancy fluid duct is going to do... Well, it's going to do the bloody job perfectly. Well, that's what I'm hoping anyway. There we go. Up. Like that. Look at this. This is absolutely stunning. Come on, please don't run out. I only could make 54 of them. These require bloody quartz, hardened quartz glass, and freaking everything. What a pain in the bum to make. Up. Okay, thank God. There you go. That's what she's looking like so far. I'm hoping that this setup is going to work. I really, really do. So we can already transfer the power to that from, obviously, those. Because we can set that to send, because that's sending out and that can receive. But obviously we need another tesseract. I need one more tesseract, and I don't have that tesseract. So I've got to unload the world very shortly. So, but what we'll do is set this one up already. This one we're going to just make up a number. There we go. It's fine, and we'll call it. I have no freaking idea what to call it. We'll just call it Ender. Out, because obviously it's going to pump out. Tick. Oh, add. Sorry. There we go. Did add? Yes, it did. And it selected too. So now that's selected. That's perfect. So now we've got to make sure, obviously, the sigil is receiving everything. It's going to receive items. Obviously, it's going to receive liquid. It doesn't need to receive energy. Obviously, it doesn't need to receive energy, which is fine. We can put it into block mode like that. So it is now, no, it's receiving items and fluid. So all water will be sucked up to there. All any other items will go straight to hopefully the nullifier. Any lava will pop out the side in these new super lama fluid duck. I don't know what bloody hell to call them. We could only make 54 of them. Bob's your uncle. That actually looks quite pretty. So we'll head on home. I'll quickly go grab myself another tesseract here. Because this here, these tesseracts are set just to send... Oh, I can't click on them. So these tesseracts here are just set to, you know, data's power out. These are all other people's on the servers. We've got to make it private. I'll show you guys how to make it private eventually. So this is only sending, obviously, energy out. And obviously, we're going to set this to obviously receive the energy. The problem is the items and liquids and everything that come out of this obviously is going to go into another tesseract to plug right into that one there. All right, so let me fly out of here. Oh, God. With no markers to get out of here, I'm bloody lost. On the minimap, oh, I don't know if you guys can see in the corner here, but where my mouse cursor is, there's actually, the dots are still there. So if we aim ourselves to that way, this way should be home. So let's get our glider out, turn off hover mode, and go this way. This way should be home. I'm hoping is home. Because we're just passing that. Yeah, I'm aiming at the orange on the minimap. There. So I'll be back soon because this is a 1,000 bloomin' block fly. Go grab myself a spear tesseract, come back out, and we'll give it a test run. Hopefully it doesn't drain, and I hope this just is enough power to keep everything going. That's what I'm hoping, and I'm going to build Watsonville. So I'll be right back, guys. Alrighty then, guys, I am back, and yes, seems to unloading and loading the world again has seemed to fix my markers, my waypoints on the Bloomer map. That was freaking weird. I haven't experienced that before, but we're almost there. I've got my spare tesseract, and we'll be able to turn all this sucker on and see if she's all working well. So, pulling up. Whoa! Don't freaking over. That was nearly a Kentucky Fried Data bit. Crikey! Alright, so pop this bad boy on. And as you can see, she is already set to ender pump out. She's already set to sending items in fluid. This guy's already set to receiving. So now let's turn it on with data's power out. Tick. Now that should be... There we go. We got liquid. Oh, come on. Oh, is there enough liquid to go? Oh, come on. You can do it. You could do it, or do we need a speed upgrade? This is going to suck if we need a speed upgrade. Because we're draining our buffer out quite quickly and not filling it back up. Do we know where it started? No, I have no clue where it started. It is not going well at all. Uh-oh. Yeah, it's not going well at all. Oh, it's climbing. It's just not enough lava pressure at all. Come on, you can do it. Okay, so hopefully the nullifier is actually working. It bloody better be, because that's going to suck. The lava is just not pressurizing, unless this new pansy pipe obviously can take metric butt tons of it, and I'm just not realizing. The buffer is going back up. So we have the 10 mil on this already. Do we want to put the speed upgrade? Do we want to put a speed upgrade on it just to see what it does? Let's get rid of this. There we go. Let's fix up. This here is data's power out. We're only receiving... We only want to be energy when receiving, so we'll block on this. There we go, so we should be receiving just energy, which is what we are. So is that 10 million? No problem. So what I want to do is try... My buffer is going up. Okay, buffer is going up. So I'll be back soon, because now I've got to fly all the way home. I want to try a speed upgrade on this and to see how it goes. Like, is it going to get more lava with a speed upgrade? I don't know. That's the whole point about testing. Test. Alright. Oh, now I've got to take the trip all the way back. If this doesn't work, obviously I've failed. which kind of sucks, but it's, hey, the whole point is trying. I was new to modded a few months ago, and the whole point is to play around, right? Right. Hashtag learning experience. If this doesn't work, I'm going to kill King Willy for telling me, your bloody idea is brilliant, it works. We'll go from there, because that's not good. All right, so I'll head on home really quickly, pick up a speed upgrade from one of the other quarries, or the actual quarry itself, and we'll plug that in and see if she's going to work a bit better. Alrighty then, guys, I am back, and again, on my way. This is ridiculous. Over 1,000 blocks every time I want to come in, we have to bloody set up a book or something, because this is not cool. Not cool for an experiment anyway. Freaking geez. Alright, 200 blocks away. Come on. I'm kind of nervous now, because it's not working how I thought it was going to go, just fire right up. Alright, so here we are, and, well, is it me, or did that just turn on and everything is maxed out? Holy smokes. Maybe speed upgrade is not necessary, and I think the Ender Quarry, if I'm correct. No, Ender Quarry is still running. Okay. Well, what the bloody hell just happened? Did I not give it enough time to warm up, maybe? I don't know. Okay, it doesn't need a speed upgrade. Look at the freaking thing, it's pressurized out the Yazoo. Everything is fine. Running absolutely bloody fine. We'll give it a speed upgrade anyway. There we go. Alright, whoops, put that back. So that there will probably be draining a lot faster. No? That's right, the Ender Quarry. Alright, so that there is... What the hell? What happened? Why is it working now? I'm lost. Did I miss something? She's maxed out. Everything here is, like, literally pressurized. Alright. Freaking, alright. So, what we'll do is load the chunks up real quick. Make sure all this stays nice and loaded. We'll do a nice square, actually. There we go. Nice and loaded up, so it never unloads. And I guess if this looks like it's working. Because I got my mining rig. My mining rig should be powering this right now. Right? It should be sending power from here. Buffer's at 10 million anyway. Just none of it is debufferizing, that's all. Alright, fine. I'm going to head back to my mining world. Make sure that is power's literally coming out. Well, where's home? Home again. 1,000 blocks away. Freaking Jesus. I'll be back shortly. I'm going to go to my mining world and make sure that power is coming out to my mining rigs from there. Because if that is that, that is working freaking A+. Absolutely bloody A+. Alrighty then, guys. I am out in my mining world and power is literally flowing through from the other side there. Oh, since I've got my hammer on me, I can finally fix this. Just get rid of that. Thank you. Finally. That was bothering me so badly. But look at this. It is working just no freaking problem. Absolutely no problem. The amount is buffered up to the 10 million mark. Look, see? Not dropping at all. Oh, crikey. Oh, that's why I need to get rid of that chest up there. But look at this. Absolutely freaking phenomenal. Fine. Perfect. I don't know what went wrong. Did I not give the quarry enough time to, like, wind up sort of thing? Or did it maybe hit a patch of obsidian straight away and I thought, oh, this is really slow and I didn't give it time to hit the lava? I don't know. All I know is that I'm getting power. It's powering itself. It's powering the pump, the end of quarry pump. Well, it's not meant to be a pump, but it's powering all of it by itself. We are definitely making more of those lava generators now. 1,000 by 1,000, we might have to move it for freaking yonks. That's bloody awesome. I'm going to head out there one last time just to double check everything. We got power the one last freaking time, and that's bloody it, because I've had enough of going out there already. I should take a freaking book and do all... I've got to set that up. Back out to the bloody lava world. Oh, all right. Ender pumps that way. So we'll head on that way. And 1,000 blocks, here we go. Which it usually doesn't go that long. It usually doesn't... The trip is not that bad at the end of the day. It's just pain in the bum when you have to do multiple trips. You forget something, guess what? You got to go back all the way there and do it. But, man, I wish I could reset this laugher world and have it, like, at the gate, you know, at the bloody door. That would be bloody nice, wouldn't it? But no, I chose something at Whoop Whoop Land. So, the actual diameters of the quarry itself, the ender quarry that I set up for the pump, is over 1,000. I think it's like 1,200 or 1,300 by 1,300. It's nuts big. So I was going to put two of these freaking quarries going too. Nowhere, don't even need it. Don't even freaking need it. All right, pulling up. Having a look. Still all pressurized and good. Well, we've lost the buffer, but look at this. Ding, 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 ding. Yep. We have now successfully solved the lava problem. Oh, we're losing buffer in this one. Oh, that one's staying, no, just nearly stable. Oh, that one's stable, 100% stable. 6.4 mil. Okay, so, yes, now she's functioning. I don't know what happened. She wasn't functioning right, but it is, we got a skip in the lava there. Did you see that? Skip in the lava. Oh, lava stopped. This must be when it's hitting something else. I think that's when the nullifier, that's probably when it's nullifying stuff. See, now it's pressurized again. There's full lava again. So I think that there is it hitting, either it's hitting these things here. See these things here? It's hitting one of these. So it's not sucking up lava and sucking up obsidian or something like that. It's a hiccup. Or it could be hitting an island because, look, there's also freaking islands out here. It could be hitting one of those freaking I don't know. But, okay, so there'll be hiccups in the power. But other than that, look, we literally have fixed our move problems. When are we going to run out of lava now? This is 1,300 by 1,300, guys. This is nuts. This here is my new lava source. This whole square here. Look at this. All this in here. Giant square of doom. Is literally all pure lava power now. That is freaking nuts. Sorry, I'm impressed. I am now finally impressed. We won't have to move this setup now for the next week. Maybe plus. I don't know. Well, this buffer is going a little bit down now. Sorry, but all I'm going to do is add more of these 64 lava generators to it so it can make up for taking... Because remember, this quarry here with a speed 3 upgrade is probably... It's maxed out at 10 mil on that. So, yes, I guarantee this quarry here is definitely taking up a bit of power because you guys know quarries do chew up a little bit of power. So, as long as I add a few more of these freaking lava generators just to make up for what it's taking out of my system, we should be right. We should be absolutely right. There's no... Oh, that's filling up quite nicely. Yeah, there's no buffers anymore. So, we're definitely going to have to add more to it because it's running multiple quarries right now. But the point is, the lava is staying up to it. It's not dropping. As long as it doesn't hit one of those things, I think it'll be fine. No water, though. Added the water. Hopefully no water goes into the line there, because I'm hoping the lava stays out there, and I'm hoping the water goes there. If not, I'm in big freaking trouble, aren't I? But it hasn't hit any water yet. It's working. It doesn't matter what. It's supplying lava as fast as it can. It's maxed out. If this was down low and it wasn't supplying lava, it couldn't take anymore. So I can keep adding layers of these 64 lava generators upwards and tesseracts until it hits to that point that lava cannot keep up with it any longer. And that means this would be obviously dropping. So that's fine. We got lots more testing to do. This is freaking awesome. Yes, I don't have to move my freaking setup anymore. Sorry, I'm happy as. No more moving setup. I just need more of these 64 multiplier generators now, and I'll be right. Oh no, we're losing. It is. It must be hitting something else. Oh, it definitely hit something else, and then it's going to pressurize again. See? Pressurized. It's pressurizing again. That's really, really weird, but then again, we already know how the ender quarry does work. So it's definitely hitting stuff. I'm not looking forward to when it hits the bloody island. That's nuts. But yeah, lava's pressurized again and lava's full again. So yes, when it does hit stuff, we're going to lose power. We're definitely going to lose a little bit of power, but that's okay. That's a sacrifice I'm willing to take. All right, guys, far out. Sorry, this has been probably a bit crazy, a long episode. I'll chop it up and make it as small as possible there, because far out, there's going to be a lot of jump cuts in this episode. But anyway, we're going to call it here. Thanks for watching episode 78 of Modern Minecraft. If you're enjoying the content, guys, please don't forget to smash those buttons, and I'll catch you all later.